What's up, fellas? I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we are playing with ST2. We don't have too many tanks to play in a tier 10 in order to fulfill our collection for a YouTube. And we are getting there, fellas. Only couple of tanks left. This one, Esterva tier 10, and the Patton. So this is a priority. After that, we'll see what we are going to do. We will drop down tier so you will see some more different gameplay. Anyways, ST2. My first impressions was not the best one about this tank, if I remember that correctly. And you know what? It did not change it. This vehicle as a tier 10 is kind of weak tank in my opinion. It's not the best vehicle in the world of tanks. It's not even debatable. But the thing is, what I want to say, this tank is... Armor of this tank is not very good, especially against the tier 10s. Gun handling is okayish. And speed is quite awful. So pretty much what you have opportunity to shoot doubles, which is majority of the times useless, and spamming one shot by one shot is just simply better. So here you go. This tank is very well balanced, but in the same time it's weak. At least this would be my opinion about this vehicle. Anyways, instead of talking too much, let's play three battles and let's see what the double penetrator is going to give for us. Am I disturbing you? Katita, am I disturbing you? Ooh, fellas, you know, it's hard with those cats over there. It's hard. It is just hard, fellas. Okay, look. What is happening right there? EBR, EBR, Ruski Light was up. Am I XEBR, EBR, EBR, Ruski Light? I can tell you... one thing, so many light tanks and three artists. This much making is already pretty much making us to fail in a game in a way, right? So what we are doing, we are going into the city and we will try to get as much use as we can over there. But it's not going to be easy, it's not going to be simple. For obvious reasons, we are not going over there because I simply don't have my umbrella on. Or maybe if I would think, well, maybe my umbrella is here. Okay, now we can play, boys and girls. Now we can play. Easy. Now look into the speed of this vehicle's and Object 705A. Even Object 705A is faster than I am, which is quite sad story. Thinking about this is like a very very big super heavy, and this vehicle not so much, right? And here we go, EBR with high explosives is penetrating us for 200 damage, Arta is hitting us for 200 damage, but not much what we can do about this. Either we are crying or either we are going in front, right? It's just how it goes, it's just how it works, speaking about this battle. As you can see, Object is taking one for the team too, and this is the game, fellas. Three clickers, five light tanks, This is one of those games which, unfortunately, but matchmaking is not treating anyone well, as wrong as it sounds, right? So pay attention at this guy. We are trying to hit him. Luckily, we managed to do so. And we are going a tiny touch more in front. And I'm going with another shot because I don't know when next time I will have a chance to shoot someone, right? And we are simply waiting until we are going to reload. And then we will try to side scrap on the corner. Maybe everything will go very, very well. That's what we are doing. Arta protection unnecessary. Yep, that was my fault. I saw how he was looking at us. Could you please let me shoot? Ay. That was quite sad, but oh well, let it be. We still have all time in the world of tanks. Fellas, you know we can penetrate him like nothing, right? If he is going to side scrap, we are going to deal with the C4 without bigger problems whatsoever. This is quite interesting stuff, is it? And as you can see, our friend managed to eliminate that guy from the game. That's what we needed. Bloodyful. Very, very bloodyful. So what to do now? This is the question, because Jeffs are having a quite good time while trying to fap on us and while trying to punish us for our stupidity in a way, right? So we need to watch out and we need to figure out what is the plan in order to keep moving front, in the front, right? That's what we need to do. And now you will see the speed of this vehicle is no bueno, right? Speed of this tank is holy moly guacamole. It's just not very good one. I'm trying to cross like this. I get the point. I completely understand how risky it is, but sometimes you need to risk it for the biscuit. And this one did not pay off. So we are down to 300 hit points right here. You know what? You might think skill. You're going to cut this battle out. No. I want to show you the reality of playing with one or another tank. Because I can pick the best battles with the double penetrators and you will say, skill, this tank is amazing. No, I don't want you to think this tank is amazing. I want to show you how the tank is looking on the daily basis and what you can expect with a vehicle overall, right? Oh yes, comrade. Kaboom! 900 in the face. That was a bloodyful one. So look, in matchmaking, which is fast matchmaking plus Artas and everything, you are going to be the first one which is going to pretty much die over there. It doesn't matter you are taking cover, you are not taking cover. It is just how the things is looking like, right? And I am feeling very, very good. I want to show you this kind of stuff. But this tank is not only one which will have this kind of situation. The TIE 5 heavy is going to be the same. The 705A is going to be the same. All those slow bastards and slow tanks overall, they are going to get destroyed in this matchmaking. Because once again, 5 lights, if it's open map, you can't do shit for them. And 3 Artas. If it's open map, you are kind of doomed. Plus on top of that, tank destroyers which have a safe defense parameter. So we try to get as much use as we could right here. And once again, I am feeling completely happy with this battle. So see you in a second and then we will play a couple of more battles with STI and hopefully we will get a bit better luck than we had in the first game. Okay, fellas? See you soon. And here we go. Battle is over, enemies captured the base, and the BRs was going like crazy, right? It is completely understandable. 5 lights in the game is not very good. 3 Artas in the game is quite bad. And probably majority of you would agree with me that battle was kind of doomed from the very first of the moment, from the very first moment when we noticed how much making was looking like. Either way, we managed to get 2,300 damage, which is hip hip hooray, and the top players light. Light, Arta, pretty much light. quite funny. Anyways, what we are going to do now, we are not giving up and we are going into the other battle, okay, fellas? Once again, those, oh my bananas. Whew, at least only one Arta. I was about to say, no talk. Why am I not getting Kempinovka when I'm playing with a light tank? I was about to start complaining, but it's okay. Not a big deal, okay? So what do we want to do? In this battle, fellas, what options do we have? Either to go onto the hill or either to go on the hill, okay? There is no other option for this vehicle. Unless the team is not going on top of the hill, then we can sit somewhere over there or something. So now we are piri piri on our 25 kilometers per hour speed when we are moving up the hill. That's how we are going to deal with the stuff over there. Plus on top of that, if you would pay attention how many light tanks enemies has, they have the 39th and they have a Z. What that basically means, we are going to blind fire them. As you can see, the 39th is over there. Now the question is where Vaza is. And if I need to guess, I would say Vaza might be in this bush over there. So what we are doing, we are stopping here for a second and we are going to say kaboom. Look at the angle and kaboom. Ooh, baby boy. Whoever was sitting in that position over there, he is not enjoying himself anymore because, some kind of hacker ST2 just hit him with the two high explosives. Although I really doubt we penetrated him because he would be dead, but either way, some hit points loss is better than none, okay? So now what we are doing, we are aiming over there and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bananas. Boom! Skill. You are a hacker, I know, but skill, you are hacking all the time. And that's why I'm not going, that's why I'm not playing in the standard bush anymore, because it's just way too easy to find the angle and to simply eliminate the person from the game. It's just simply too easy, as you can see. And that guy is not very happy. This guy is probably on the full banana mode right there, because probably he did not saw that one coming. Someone can blind fire him over there, right? Anyways, not a big deal. All we need to do right there, we need to raise the gun and we need to go for a double in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Kaboom! Beautiful. So what we are doing, we are going on top of the hill, as you can see. Easy, fellas, easy. They have more forces over there. They have 4 guns, we have 3 guns, but we have 2 guns overall, and maybe if we are going to sit perfectly hold down, it's not going to be that bad. And the most dangerous tank for me in this kind of situation is obviously enemy Super Conqueror, if he's going to go with APCRs, which more likely he will. Probably Arta. So those 2 tanks are very, very dangerous. This tier, 8 shitter, I don't really care. I don't care about the Lance and Sea. I don't mind about the other guy which was over there, Double Penetrator, or however it's called. It just doesn't matter for us. All we want to do, we want to eliminate the Super Conqueror as fast as possible, right? Arta just smacked our standard B, which is unfortunate, and now we are going in. Super Conqueror should be very, very close over there. Okay. First of all, 750 in the face, and I am feeling Gucci. We are going to go with the doubles right here, because I don't want to get spotted that many times, right? If that makes sense. If that makes sense, fellas. Super Conqueror is going in. I'm going in too. Super Conqueror is thinking, oh my bananas. And I'm saying, yes, me. And double penetration into his tracks. Really? Game? Really? Did I did something bad for you? Ay-yay-yay-yay-yay-yay. That was unfortunate, my lovely friends. That was very, very unfortunate. Don't die, sir. Okay, look, Super Conqueror, he's going to take 800 for the team in approximately 3 seconds or so. That's what we need, okay? So let's go. Kaboom. 900 in the face. That was beautiful one. Okay, what we are going to do right here, we are going to repeat everything, in approximately some seconds, right? Like 10 seconds. Then, when Super Conqueror is going to be dead, then we can start playing. As wrong as it sounds, we need to do this. Kaboom. Super Conqueror is dead. Good. And now, we are playing the game. So, this guy is down to one-shottable. This guy is double-tappable. Oh, that's what we want to see. This is so far so good, fellas. This game is definitely not the game for which we would need to worry about or something, right? It's just a good game for us. Let's see. Can we play hold down and can we penetrate this guy with a standard ammunition? Oh yes, we can. I'm going one by one. It is completely fine. We are going to wait for 7 seconds and we will try to eliminate this person from the game over there. I'm quite happy Arta is not trying to hit me or simply eliminate me from the game. I don't really understand why, but it's not my business. If Arta is not trying to kill me, I am actually happy. So let's see, I am pretending I'm not looking at him, but in reality I was looking at him, and after 2 seconds this guy is going to die. Actually, he died even quicker. It is completely fine. Moving on, next. What do we want to do now? As you can see, the E50M is over there, okay? So we need to think about this guy which is sitting somewhere here in the back. Chill, relax, take it easy, wait for it. Whenever he's going to get spotted, we are going to peek with a double right there. Plus on top of that, VK Bushwanker, T-55 Bushwanker, everyone is over there. Actually, I could even go with a blind shot, I assume. By the way, E-50M is probably escaping, I assume, because this guy did not took for the team. So this is only one way how the things could go, right? Mm-hmm. As you can see, 50M is not over there. Good. Very good. Our budget, though, got outspotted. This is quite interesting stuff. Okay, let's see. What we want to do right here, we want to go with a double blind shot. I was trying to hit this guy over there, but probably I missed. And oh no, the Progetto is making a hardcore pressure here in front. Aye, 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 aye. We missed opportunity to double tap someone, but it's completely fine. Not the first time, not the last time. Let's keep going. Slowly but surely. Little by little and step by step. They're trying to get closer right there. Good. As you can see, Progetto is moving from the bush to the bush. That's what we need. And hi there. Kaboom. I'm spotted. I don't really mind. There is not too many people which could penetrate me frontally unless they are shooting hit. So once again, I kind of don't mind. And our Progetto is making a hardcore pressure right there. I just wonder from where he got farmed. The enemy Progetto is sitting right there, but he is going to get killed by our Bushwanker sniper schnitzels from the base, right? And there is a Centurion, which we can't see because our mobility is unfortunately not the best one. And E50M is somewhere. Okay, let's hope the E50M is over there so we can get double tap, okay, before this battle will end. That would be my dream in this battle. And remember, we blindshotted the enemy light tank in the start of the battle, so this battle is not that horrible. By the way, as you can see, he's dealing with me like nothing, and I'm going with a blind shot over there because I feel like maybe he's over there, and I'm getting killed. Frontally, no armor whatsoever. Here you go. This is a good point, fellas. You can see how this vehicle is performing in the game and how the things is looking like with this tank. Yes, we have 4,200 damage in this battle, but remember, I was a top tier. For example, if I would be with a Kranwagen, I would farm way more than this just because I would be on the hill and I would butts. All those lower tier tanks, they would scream, owee, owee. That's how everything would look like, right? Although, it's not a horrible game, let's get real. I have seen worse battles than this, that's what I'm trying to say right there. Okay, now we can choose the reward which we want. You know what, I really don't mind. Just chew. Just chew away, I don't care. So, yeah, as I said, 4,200 damage, that was hip hip hooray, and this poor light tank which died in the first moment because he did not move and he took one for the team, right? Did I penetrate it? Oh, I penetrated only two, so with high explosives I did not hit him at all. Oh, his fuel tanks got on fire, so probably maybe he lost a lot of the hit points because of the fire. Yeah, you never know, doesn't matter. Anyways. The last battle with a ST2. Come on, ST2. Show something nice. Buddy, ST2, you are not that bad as a tank, okay? How about let me have a good performance? ST2. I hope for a tier 9 battle in the map. For example, in the city map. For example, Ruinberg. Either Ruinberg or either Siegfried Line. Siegfried Line defense. Am I asking too much? I hope not. Yeah, I want to show you something good, okay? And as you can see, this tank is not epic vehicle as majority of us thought when this tank just came into the game. It's definitely not the best tank in the world of tanks. You can't trust me on this one. Okay, what I'm doing, there is two options. Either going into the heavy line or either going into the... medium tank line / heavy line, however you are calling this. And we need to make a decision right here. You know, I could actually go... At first I could go with a blind shot. Should I? That's what I am thinking. Why so? Because if I will take this bush over there, I can try to blind fire someone and then we can piri piri like this. Yeah, why not to do that? Boop, 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 boop. Soon, fellas. 6 seconds left and we will go with a blind shot. Soon, fellas. So the first victim which we are going to blind fire is going to be in the standard bush, right? This is the most important thing for us. About which standard bush am I talking about? Oh, yes. About this one. You never know, but that wasn't the best shot ever. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to make a hardcore pressure right here. As you can see, there is a feast of the tier 8s. So what do we want to do? We want to deal with those tier 8s for obvious reasons, right? So let's go. And believe me, those tier 8s, they are thinking, what the flying F have we done already, okay? Because our team is making a hardcore pressure. This Pantera is dead. Either I will be able to kill him or not. And the answer is yes. Good. All we need to do now, we need to keep making pressure right here. As you can see, Lorraine is saying, oh no, mamma mia. And I'm saying, not that, not so fast. Our standard B, stock standard B, is beating the crap out of this guy over there. And all we need to do, we need to keep making a hardcore pressure. This is the most important thing for us, right? We need to eliminate whoever is sitting around this area over there. And double penetration in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Actually, he's going on top of the... He's going against the 5 tanks just to avoid me. And you know what? I am allowing him to do so. What can I say? If he decided to go in this way, what can I do? Tracking shot into this guy. Meanwhile, the Jeff is still trying to fap on me, which is kind of sad thing, but I can't change it. And we know they have 2 bushwankers over there, right? In this bush. Right there. That's what we need to keep in mind, my lovely friends. Bushwankers is over there. Meanwhile, the Škoda is getting spotted, which I don't really care. And in this kind of matchup, in this kind of matchmaking, fellas, this tank is feeling like a heavy tank, okay? Why this vehicle is feeling like a heavy tank? Because there is only one Jeff, and the tanks with which we are playing against is like lower tiers, right? So that's quite nice thing for us. Now this guy might think he escaped, but in reality it's definitely the case. He escaped. I told you many times, I have some addictions. One of addiction is jumping and another addiction is double penetration. What can I do if I have a chance to see 1000 from a heavy tank in the face? I mean, what did you expect it from my side? Tell me, but be honest, what did you expect it? Obviously, if I have a chance to hit someone for shit ton of damage, I'm going to do that. And it's not even debatable, it's not even discussable. If I have a chance, I will do this. Okay, light tank over there, not a big problem whatsoever, and I want to see this Foch which is sitting over there, right? Meanwhile, that Arta is still beating the crap out of me, but I kind of deserved it, right? Meanwhile, Lorraine is over there, Super Conqueror is over there, and Lorraine is actually penetrating me, which I really want to get rid of him. Boom, blind shot, unfortunately, I did not manage to do that, and as you can see, Sheridan is in the side, right? You know what is the weirdest and the worst thing for me right here, as wrong as it sounds? This Foch, which is sitting over there. Meanwhile, Arta is still fapping on us, it is completely fine, we are moving pir backwards, and we are... We will try to survive this. And as you can see, Foch in the same position, once again, just doing whatever he wants to do. Sheridan, he's going to peek in a second, and let's believe, unfortunately, that was not the case, and Arden coming in 3, 2, 1, yep. Okay, so speaking about this battle, boys and girls, did I play well this battle? No, I didn't. Why I didn't play well? Because I thought I can't go in front. I thought, oh my bananas, all enemy guns is looking at us and our team, maybe they are going to go boom, 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 like this, or maybe we are going to have a support or something. In reality, that was not the case, but it's completely fine. It's understandable. It is how it is. No complaints, no regrets. You think we are over? No. One more battle, because I haven't had a very good game with this tank in a while. By the way, my average performance of this tank is like 3000 damage. No, I'm not joking. Heavy tank, tier 10, 3000 damage. Recently, I got Mark of Excellence up to 100% in 70-ish games in the RU server with T54. I managed to get 3,500. With this tank, I'm struggling to play. I'm just struggling. It's not my vehicle. I hate it. And I think this tank is actually crap because it's different, which is kind of good. It's different tank because once again, it's not that often when you can create a different tank and make it exciting to play, but in the same time, it's just not good. It needs something more because it's just too slow. Or maybe it's just because of me, because I'm not playing well. Anyway, see you in a second and one more battle with this pile of Kaku. Let's go. And we are back. It took quite some time, unfortunately. I messed up and that was my fault. We lost this game. I simply thought I have a lot of hit points so I can go in front and I can get a lot of use. But okay, let's get real. It was not the best decision from my side, right? I completely messed up over there and that was my fault why our team actually lost. This guy managed to farm a lot. Sheridan farmed quite a lot and so on. It was my fault. Oh well, what can you do? Better luck next time. Okay, the last battle with the ST2. For F's sake, ST2, you beautiful thing. Give me tier 10 matchmaking, but give me something nice. I'm speaking about the map, okay? I will try to play hold down and I will try to play well. I don't need lower tiers. Give me higher tiers. It doesn't matter. All I want to do, I want to get a good map, not open shit field. Come on. Do this. Or side scrapping map, okay? Which is still the city after all. Come on. Come on, matchmaking. I will be a good boy. I know this tank is not good and I know that. Stop crying, kid. Show what you got. Okay. What we are doing? We are going over there. That's what we are going to do. We will try to find one or another shot into the enemy forces which is playing around this area, or maybe we will side scrap on this corner. We'll see. I will do what Heavy is supposed to do and we'll see. Maybe then our performance is going to be tiny touch better than before, right? And once again, my lovely friends, I am trying to play well. I'm not suiciding on purpose or something with ST2, but this vehicle is just simply, as a tank itself, it's just not my favorite one. And I was struggling to get Mark of Excellence on this vehicle too. So, and you know, I was talking with a lot of people on stream. I said, fellas, what do you think about this tank? And like 99% of the people said this tank is just a pile of Kaku. That's why the things is not looking that well and that's why I'm struggling. Although this is not an excuse. I know what I can do in the game and I know how I can play, right? Anyways, stop complaining, skill, and start playing. Hiya, Captain. So the first things first. I want to get the first shot into the person which is going to go over there, right? So what we are doing, we are turning our gun into this side a bit and we are going up. Whenever I will see someone, I will make a decision. Do I want to go for a double? Do I want to go for a single? This is very, very important thing. So we will maximize how much use we can get of all this, right? And what we noticed right here, we noticed that enemies have no team whatsoever. And double, boom. I know where he is. Okay, good. That was a beautiful start. We did everything properly right here. Now the question is, Do I want to go for it or not? Should I or I shouldn't? I think I will. That was definitely not a blind shot. What I mean by saying that, we definitely did not manage to hit him. That's what I said. And the next is going to go over there, okay? Just a bit in the side. It is completely fine. We have all time in the world of tanks. And if I hit the, and if I will hit the shot, it's going to be amazing. Let's see. Definitely not a hit. Worth a try anyways. It's okay. That was a try from our side to blind fire over there. And as you can see, our people is pushing via the beach, which is not the best thing ever, but oh well, not much what we can do about that. And right here, we are just waiting until the enemies are going to make one or another mistake, right? That's what we want to see. So let's do this. Wait for it. Scorpion G is sitting over there, right? Which is completely understandable. It is completely fine. I kind of want to see. Aha! He lost one hit point, so I splash at him. Ah, that was the case. This could be the case. Can I go for a double? No, I cannot. So I went for a single. But too bad I didn't manage it to penetrate this convoy like this. That was quite sad thing. Oh well. Not much what I can do about that. Convoy is looking at me. I'm looking at convoy. I am hitting him and I am smiling after the hit. Good. Very, very good. Meanwhile, the MX-30 is thinking how to make my life tiny touch shitter. But it's not going to be so easy for him. Because I am not going to peek against him. Unless I will have some kind of chance to kill him. Right? This guy is peeking sideways. We are trying to eliminate him from the game. And luckily we eliminated him from the game. This time I'm playing so much safer with this vehicle. And I'm trying to think as much as I can what I'm doing. Not to do some stupid mistakes. Speaking about mistakes. One shot into the side, which is good, and I'm going for another one just because I can, and another one. That was quite stupid, not gonna lie, but it's completely fine, right? Meanwhile, the E-75 is taking one for the team from the Mr. Clicker, and I'm dropping down. That was not my intention, but sometimes it happens, right? So it's completely fine. It is completely okay. I lost some time over there, but oh well, what can you do? So what we are going to do now, we are going to go piri piri like this and we are going to take the middle over there. And once again, the main question is how much use we can get in this battle. Because by the looks of it, actually this battle is quite close. Although enemies, majority of the enemies is camping in the back right there. So maybe we will be able to go there in time and buts, simply to deal with them. We'll see. It's kind of hard to talk about this, what will happen. It is kind of hard to guess what will happen in this battle, right? And now look, what is striking us the most in this battle? Speed is striking us the most. Why so? Because this tank is simply slow, right? And this is very, very important thing. And this could be even a highlight of this vehicle. If the tank is slow, in the end of the battle, you are simply... It's very, very hard for you to reach the damage in the end, right? It's just simply hard. And this is what is happening in this battle. Our team, our faster big boys, they are going super aggressively and they are simply eliminating everyone what is left in the battle. And we are going like a turtle in the slow speed. And we are just trying to get some kind of use over there. This guy is trying to run. Obviously, I missed the first shot because my pre-aim was quite bad. And we are going for the second one. And we are trying to hit him. And obviously, he's getting eliminated. Here you go. The fourth battle. My lovely friends. From the bottom of my heart, I'm telling you. Whenever I'm playing aggressively with this tank, I am getting effed frontally. Because of this cupola, even T-Raids can penetrate it without bigger problems whatsoever. I'm not even speaking about the lower plate, right? The higher tiers can penetrate you however they want to. The quick conclusion about this tank, right? And I'm being 100% honest. This tank is just, in my opinion, it's not good tank in the current World of Tanks and in the current game meta. I think it's just bad tank. And at least my performance is showing that. 3,300 damage, 800 assisting damage. When I was marking it and when I was tryharding. Meanwhile, as a comparison, Mr. Mouse. With Mouse we have the same score. E-100, 3,600 plus 900. Panzer, 3,900. Let's say like that, let's check 705, 3,600. Right? Let's check 277. 3.8 plus way more assisting damage. Even T22 have pretty much the same score about the damage, right? But way more assisting damage. It's just not my cup of tea. And the main conclusion of all this, I do not recommend this vehicle because it's just simply weak tank in the current meta. And I think it's quite bad tank overall. How did we play today? Today, fellas, we played for 2,700 damage, which was not super horrible, but it wasn't good. And and we played for the 700 assisting damage, which once again was below average, and unfortunately the games did not went too well. But oh well, I am showing you the score which you are going to get with this vehicle, and probably the highlight of all this was the Kempinovka game when we blind shot at someone. That was fun. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill. I try to get as much use as I could with ST2, but sometimes it can be hard and it can be pain in the ass. Anyways, thank you. See you tomorrow, fellas, and I hope you enjoy the video. Skill is out. Peace.